Hi everyone, so today I started working on the modification of the 42171, which is the AMG Mercedes F1. So here is the current progress. I managed to install an L motor which will be controlling the steering system here via 224 tooth gears. And here is my, let's say, cheat sheet. So basically I'm using this 3D LDD model, which I already pre-made. And you can see how the L motor will be integrated here. And it will be steering the wheels and the steering wheel, so this functionality will be preserved. And here is a BuWizz 3.0, which is placed right behind the driver's seat, and it is driving the single BuWizz motor, which is actually oriented so it's like right behind the driver's seat and between the motor and the BuWizz. And that single BuWizz 3 is driving the BuWizz motor, and that motor is driving the rear differential via this CV joints and slightly gear down, so we have more than enough torque to drive this heavy model. So this is the theory, and let's see how well it goes in practice. So the front section and the rear section have been successfully joined, and here in the center we have the BuWizz 3.0 driving the drive motor and of course controlling the steering motor. Right behind the drive motor we have the V6 fake engine, and actually I'm using the BuWizz motor's quick output to drive the V6 directly, and then the slow output is using CV joints to drive this gear here, which is then driving the differential and of course the drive wheels. So now that everything mechanical is completed, it's just time to put on the bodywork. So here is the completed 42171 motorization. We have a single BuWizz motor driving the rear wheels, and behind the driver's seat we have the BuWizz 3.0. The BuWizz 3.0 can be activated by pressing the driver's seat backwards, and you can also remove the seat for easy charging. There have been almost no visual changes, so the model is very close to the original when it comes to aesthetics, and I'm really happy with how it turned out. And as you can see here, I also built a small dyno, and we can see what kind of a speed we can reach. So we reached around 9 km/h on the dyno, and we'll see how fast it actually goes outside on asphalt. I think it should go slightly faster because this dyno does have a bit more friction compared to real ground, but we'll see. So I am really happy how it turned out, even though I'm only using one motor. I still think this project came out much better than the previous McLaren F1. It's much more robust, much more reliable, and I also think it looks much cooler. So next time we're gonna be driving it outside.